She is a very distinguished Toastmaster, and I believe, and I'm certain about this, that sooner than later, she will be the first person from India to be an accredited speaker for the Toastmaster International. Now, for those of you who don't know what accredited speakers are all about, it's an elite group of speakers who represent Toastmasters, and they go around the world representing Toastmasters. If you don't believe what I'm saying, you've got to just see her this evening when she makes her presentation. It's my honor and privilege to welcome to the Bangalore Toastmasters Club my friend and a champion speaker, Mala Martin. We all love good speakers, don't we?
Yes.
And this year is the 50th death anniversary of one of the greatest orators of the 20th century. He gave us such incredible quotes. Things like, "I have nothing to offer but blood, toil, tears, and sweat." And in his speeches, there were such lovely phrases like, "This was the evening, it was their finest," or "We shall fight on the beaches." Who do you think I'm talking about?
Washington.
Winston Churchill. Churchill, what a man. I don't really admire him as a politician, because he was dead against giving freedom to us. But I admire the quality of the man, his erudition, and the way he handled his failures. He was born with the proverbial silver spoon in his mouth. His father was an aristocrat, was a duke, was a member of parliament, a very prominent politician. His mother, one great beauty from America, who had immense charm and great influence in British top circles. With that kind of background, you would expect Churchill's life to be a breeze life, right? But that wasn't the case. Churchill struggled through school. He was a hopeless student. He flunked his 10th standard. His teachers thought he was no good. He can't make it to university. And so he thought the next best thing would be to join the military. The military college at Sandhurst. He wrote the entrance exam and he failed. He tried again next year, the second year, he failed again. On his third attempt, he finally made it. Obviously, he was not the brightest person living in Great Britain at that time. But still, he became one of the finest prime ministers that Great Britain had. He became one of the greatest orators the world had ever seen. And top it all, he also won the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1953. How did he do it? What did he do to reinvent himself? Let's focus on Churchill as an orator for want of time. How did he become such a great orator? Was he a born orator? No, he wasn't. He didn't really have an attractive voice. Particularly in his initial years, he spoke in a monotone. There wasn't much variation in his voice or pitch or volume. Worse, he couldn't pronounce the word S. Can you imagine what a huge trauma it would be if you know that you cannot pronounce a particular letter? And it's not that he didn't have his public speaking gaffes. In 1904, when he was speaking in the British House of Commons, 45 minutes into his speech, he forgot his lines. And he kept looking, staring, trying to remember, as he described, his three most embarrassing minutes in his life. He couldn't recollect what he had to say. He just sat down silently and was humiliated. A man like that, how did he invent? It is simple. Churchill spent at least 6 hours reading. He would meticulously craft his speeches. He would type it out in such a way that he can deliver his speeches forcefully. And he would practice, pace up and down, practice, rehearsing ad nauseum. Friends, there is no shortcut to success. You may fail, but you gotta pick yourself up, and there's only one mantra to succeed, and that is to practice. And that's what this platform offers us, right? And that's what we all come here for. And if you stutter, if you stumble, don't worry. Even the great Churchill dried up. In fact, later on in his life, he was asked, what was his greatest success? He didn't talk about his oratory, that he has the entire world spellbound. He didn't speak about the Nobel Prize that he won. He said, success is when you move from failure to failure without loss of enthusiasm. Success is when you move from failure to failure without loss of enthusiasm. That, in a way, is the theme of this evening too. You may falter, but pick yourself up. So let's soldier on with that spirit as we try to enhance our own public speaking skills in our lovely club. On that note, it gives me great privilege and it's an honor to welcome on stage the next speaker, the Toastmaster of the day, Prakash Tamankar. Now, Prakash is God sent to this club. He is an asset, and saying that is actually an understatement. He's not part of any committee. He's not a president, not a vice president, not part of anything. But when I took over last month, and when I looked at the website, I suggested to my vice president, PR, that we should do something about it. He sent out a word, and Prakash volunteered to help him out. He didn't have to, but he works day in and day out to make this club better. And he did that by doing a sterling job in overhauling our website, which he and Mahavir will inaugurate this evening. So I'm delighted, Prakash, that you are with us, that you've come back to our club after a span of 6 or 7 years, and that you've come back during my term. I am so delighted. Please put your hands together for Prakash Tamankar.